Nobody wants to get united. Like, what we gotta do is meet everybody at home 49th Street at the bench.
Welcome back to the bench, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're gonna keep the trend going. I already made a 5 top mistakes graffiti artists make on hairstyles and throw-ups, so I figured today we'll go ahead and knock out pieces as well. If you haven't seen those videos already, I'll have them in the cards up here. Now, because we're only taking a look at 5 mistakes new graffiti artists make, I want you guys to leave what you believe to be some really common mistakes new graffiti artists make on pieces in the comments down below. I'd love to hear it. So, mistake number 1. New graffiti artists forget that they're doing graffiti. In other words, they forget about letter structure. Like Tracy168 said, if you're gonna add style, you can lose the letter, but you can't lose the letter. And what essentially that means is you still have to have the letter's structure there by the end of all of your style. Because once again, we're doing graffiti, we're writing, meaning that we have to spell something. But new graffiti artists, they don't care about structure, so they sacrifice it. The structure just goes downhill immediately to the point where it's not even there at the end, meaning that they're not even spelling much of anything, and their letter structures are completely destroyed. And every experienced graffiti artist can tell you that your letter's structure is by far the most important part of graffiti. No amount of style is going to save a broken letter. Which this immediately correlates to number 2, is they add way too much style. Every new graffiti artist should only be focusing on basic print font pieces. That's it. And mind you, that's only if they want to progress and get better. That's if they want to practice. If they're just doing it for fun and that's the only thing they care about, then they can do whatever it is they want to do. But when it comes to progress, when it comes to practice, when it comes to getting better in this art form, basic straight letters with absolutely zero style. This is inevitably the part where somebody in the comments says,
"But John, graffiti isn't all about style."
And for newer graffiti artists, don't look at those comments and immediately think, "Oh yeah, this person's right." No, that person does not understand how style functions, because all style is the exaggeration of the fundamentals. And that's true for every single art form, meaning if you want to have a functionable style, then you have to understand the fundamentals in order to be able to do it. There's a reason why every single old school graffiti legend and every single artist in history always puts an emphasis on learning the basics. Another huge mistake that newer graffiti artists make is the letter's thickness. Now, I'm not talking about the actual letter itself, I'm talking about the individual boxes of the letter. This is gonna be really confusing for a lot of graffiti artists, because varying the width of the box can end up changing where your boxes connect to one another. And connecting your boxes is already a confusing topic for a lot of graffiti artists, which if you have trouble with that, I have a video for it right here. Be sure to check that out. But when you're first starting off, it's a lot easier to manage boxes that are all the same width. And as you get better, you'll kind of get used to tapering your boxes off to be larger or thinner. Regardless of how you taper your boxes, just be sure that they still connect on a vertice or a vertex, and you should be fine. And this actually directly correlates to the next one as well, which is letter weight. So the issue with letter name weight and the way this correlates to an individual box's thickness is a lot of newer graffiti artists won't think about the overall letter's weight and how that correlates to the rest of the name. You want your entire piece to weigh about the same. You don't want one side to look too heavy and the other side to look much lighter. Obviously, the more advanced you become, the more you can mess with this concept. And the way this correlates to the individual box thickness is because newer graffiti artists, they'll experiment with making certain things thinner and certain things thicker, but they won't consider the overall impact of that. And as a result, an individual box being thinner can mean the difference to that side of the name having less weight. And of course, a box being thicker can result in one side of the name being too heavy. Now, for the last one, I wanted to include something very kind of obscure that not a lot of people talk about, and that's doing your pieces at the bottom of the page. And advanced graffiti artists can do many of these and make it work. But a newer graffiti artist doing a piece at the bottom of the page messes everything up. Because as a newer graffiti artist who's aspiring to become better in this art form, you need to practice the basics. When you do your piece at the bottom of the page, what ends up happening is the bottom of the page carries all of your name's weight for you. You don't have to work for name weight. And what this does is it prevents you from learning and practicing letter structure, because you're not practicing the bottoms of any of those letters. We already talked about how it carries your name's weight. It throws off your negative space management, because a lot of letters have open counters on the bottom portion of the letter that you have to balance out. It also really takes care of letter name positioning for you as well, so you don't get to practice that either. And your flow is completely dictated by that bottom of the page. And all of these things remain true for putting your name on the way left or the way right or the top. So this really just prevents you from practicing any of the basics. When you're just starting off in graffiti and you're still learning, you definitely want to be doing your pieces in the center of the page. That way you can practice all of these fundamentals the way they're meant to be practiced. And you can progress at all of these things. But those are the top 5 mistakes I see new graffiti artists make on pieces. Of course, there are a ton of different mistakes that newer graffiti artists make, and some that I just just didn't have time to mention in this video, so guys, let me know in the comments down below, what do you consider to be the top 5 mistakes newer graffiti artists make? Let's have a discussion about it. Anyway, that brings us to the end of today's video. If you guys enjoyed it, let me know in the comments down below, and be sure to hit that like button as it helps out a bunch. For those of you guys who are new here, feel free to subscribe. We come out with 2 graffiti videos a week, and this is by far the best place online to learn about graffiti. Anyway, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Until then, peace.